singer and songwriter whose hits like Customer and Guess Who Loves You More made us either want to fall in love or actually we were in love.
And this one-stop shop for R&B and soul continues to make moves with his new album, The Love Reunion, which dropped today. Please welcome down to the circle, the Love King, Raheem Devaughn. Yay!
Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
All right. Raheem, how
looking
are
shy,
you?
By
how
time.
You doing?
Have
Thank
a
you.
Seat.
I look beautiful as well.
You know what? When you come down to the circle, every time we see you, wherever we
shy.
Are, because we see them a lot.
Yeah.
And you always look good. You always give us a look.
You represent.
Okay. I mean, I like your frames. You got your color on today. What is that? What
I
type of blue is that? Is that
cobalt
blue?
Everybody wearing these frames.
Yeah, you're looking good. Yeah. You got it pulled together. That's always per usual.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Well, we're coming off the heels of the BET Awards, and mm-hmm. of course, we're at the tail end of Black Music Month. Where do you think exactly Black music is today in the genre of music overall?
I think it's in a great space. You know, from an independent standpoint as well as a major standpoint, you got a lot of great new millennial artists out there that's doing their thing. You know what I mean? So, I think today is like June 28th. Uh-huh. It's like awesome for music, for Black music.
Course.
I just dropped a new album.
Yes, of course it's awesome. You just
awesome
bless the
music.
People.
Yeah. Yes. And you still got another banging album that you had released before that's still winning.
Yeah, this is my second album in the last 9 months. You
absolutely,
know?
Wow. Yeah.
Yeah, definitely, yeah. It's a, you know, continuation of something we've started, you know, in terms of R&B. It's like a trilogy series I put out. Yeah, mm-hmm. right now.
And that's what's cool about the music industry right now. There is no, you know, strict blueprint like it used to be back in the day. We kind of can do whatever we want. Speaking of which, Raheem and I have done a duet on my new album,
yeah.
which is called
oh, good.
Woman,
yeah.
which I had to get him because one of my favorite songs by him is Woman, Woman, yeah. Woman, Beautiful Woman, which is his song.
Mm-hmm.
So, but talk to us, Raheem. What is it? Why is it important for artists like us to collaborate in this era, like R&B? Why do we need to stick together? Why do we need to collaborate?
I think collaboration's always been important, but it's no time like the present. Mm-hmm. You know, black music, R&B music, and soul music in particular is the only music that's treated like it's disposable mm-hmm. at times. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. In my opinion. You know what I mean? And I feel like, you know, in terms of, and across the gamut for black music and black execs, we the only ones that kind of tell other black artists that we can't do different genres of music.
That is correct.
You know what I mean? They experiment with different things. So I think it's more, it's no time like the present. I think it definitely keeps our culture thriving and keeps it alive, you know. But more importantly, you know, collaborations are great because you never know of all different types of lanes and genres, because you never know what's gonna happen from that.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
You know what I mean? And the goal is always to make, I know for me, the goal is always to make a solid body, top timeless piece of work, you know?
Right,
that's
absolutely.
Real good. I like that, something, some Al Green type of music,
yeah,
you know, that's timeless, I like it a lot.
Yeah.
This is your seventh album, okay,
yeah.
The Love Reunion.
Yeah.
What are you hoping that people take away from this body of work, and why is it so personal to you?
The music is all personal to me. You know, it's for me, I hope it shows my growth as a vocalist, as a mm-hmm. songwriter, always. That's the goal.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the Love Reunion project in particular, it's like Decade of a Love King Part 2. So it's just like, mm-hmm. you know, most of my albums, it could be, you know, they could be turned into plays or films. You know,
mm-hmm.
I feel like it's like kind of a storyline.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very like meticulous about the track
mm-hmm.
listing and what song goes here and goes
right.
there.
Mm.
But I also, you know, experimented with, you know, Afrobeat, Afro Soul. I got a record on there called Kiss by the Sun
mm-hmm.
for all our melanated
yes,
sisters.
Come through.
All you melanated mm-hmm. sisters out there. and then also a record called Magnet that has a Caribbean, you know, Jamaican vibe, reggae vibe, as well as like a reggaeton kind of vibe. So, you know, I'm embracing the idea of like hearing myself in the club, but the way and seeing people dance to the music, not just make love to the music.
Mm.
You know,
you want the people to do everything.
Yeah, I want you to do everything. I want you to do everything to the music. Do everything you can.
And speaking of this music, what was the songwriting process like in this album that makes it different from all the other Raheem albums?
I wouldn't say that there's any songwriting process that makes it necessarily different, other than physically, I don't write things down. Mm-hmm. So I kind of just go in there, you know. I was in the studio.
So the emotion, what was your emotion then?
Well, I mean, it's love-induced always, okay. You know what I mean? But this album in particular, it's a very sensual and euphoric, you know, can I say orgasmic during the day?
Well, can I say that? I guess we can say
yes, we can. We just did, and yes. On this good note.
Yeah, euphoric and orgasmic.
Well, all right, that's a party right there.
I know, that's fine. And we are having such a great time with you. And if you're staying the full hour, you can also have a great time with him as well, because when we come back, we will be with Raheem Devaughn talking about his new album, The Love Reunion, so you don't want to miss it.
And it streams on all platforms. Also, the conversations continue on all social media platforms
right
at SisterCircleTV.com. And just like that, we're back. We've been hanging with the love king himself, Honey Raheem Devaughn, getting to him, I'm telling you. And since we're on the tail end of Black Music Month, we thought that we will dive into your music to see what was behind all of it, the love, the laughter, and the fun.
Well, we'll dive
Trina,
in,
get
baby.
Into
here
it.
Go,
here
you go.
Here yes,
go.
I got
Ooh.
My
Dive,
CD.
Baby.
I got
Dive.
My
Dive.
CD.
For me,
dive
I got my
in.
CD.
Gibson,
I got
yeah,
my
baby.
CD. I'm playing
all
it
right.
In the car.
So we're going to them, though, for real, real, huh?
We're going to dig into your brain a little bit.
Okay.
Okay, we're going to talk about your lyrics called Woman. I'm going to read them back to you.
All right, cool.
What you had said was, I appreciate your glow.
Thank you.
And when you get angry with us, the way that you let us know, and I think it's so cute when you get so emotional. Mm. You know, till you prove your point, you just can't let it go. But I like that, though.
Mm.
Okay. So, what do you make of people who misconstrue the passion that Black women have?
It's funny. It's funny.
Inherently.
It's funny.
For anger.
It's funny you say that. I think I was going to say that. I think often, you know, a Black woman's passion is confused with misconstrued with anger.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like
that's
you know,
real talk.
You know, but I think that's just the that's just her sense of urgency.
Mm.
It just makes her
message.
It just makes her unique, you know.
But why do you want to go back and forth with the woman anyway? Have the woman get all deep into her passion?
Yeah. Why you want to go back and forth with any woman, right?
I'm just asking the man.
Because y'all just right.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all right when y'all wrong.
I'm asking for a friend.
That's true. We right when we wrong. That is
as long
true.
As you know it. Okay then, Lena. That's on
what you got, Lena. What
the
you
next
got?
Song is "Don't Come Easy."
Hey.
Okay, and this is what you told the people down to. Don't come easy. You said love. Don't come easy. Gotta put in work for play. Gotta make sure you're ready for pain. Love don't come easy. Gotta sacrifice every day. Mm. Gotta make sure you're willing to change.
Boy, I know all
the
right
love king. Okay, then. I'm sure you've experienced highs and lows when it comes to love. Do you think people give up on love because they don't understand the work that is involved? Or is it more that they're just unwilling to do the work?
I don't think that's the only reason people give up on love. I think there's a lot of different reasons. Unfortunately, everything has an expiration date.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So
that's true too.
I think the best kind of love to try to chase is the type of love that that has the untimely demise, you know, to it. You know what I mean? But it's trial and error. We're all human. We're all projects in construction.
Yeah, hey.
You know
Raheem.
What I mean?
Uh-oh. Did I just hear you say that love don't last forever?
No, I'm not saying that love don't last forever.
I'm saying that
true love should last forever.
Okay.
I think true love lasts forever.
Okay.
You know,
right.
It lasts beyond the grave. You know what I mean? When it's true love.
That's true.
I'm saying that there are some people out here that are in what you call long-term breakups.
Long-term breakups.
What is that?
It's a long-term breakup.
You can be in a level of comfortability, just kind of going through the motions and just like.
Oh,
maybe,
but y'all been broke up.
But
y'all going through the formalities.
Yeah, I mean.
Or you just staying for stuff that it has nothing.
That has nothing to do with matters of the heart.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Okay. I never did that. Long-term breakup.
That's deep. You went on down to the belly.
But it don't come easy. Keep trying for it. If you need it, just all you got to do is just get with the love reunion. In stores now. Available. All digital platforms, currently number 5, headed for number 1 on iTunes. R&B and Soul charts.
You just dropped today. You're already number 5.
Please.
All right,
do your thing.
But ladies, you don't want to find yourself in a long-term breakup, okay? So watch yourselves.
All fellas.
Well, I'm going to speak for the ladies.
And I'm going to speak for the fellas.
Well, I know we took. See, there's two Tauruses right here.
Well, let's touch and agree then.
Come on. Well, okay, then, in touch.
All right.
I agree.
Mm-hmm. Lord,
all right, let's move right along. Okay, let's talk about this new song, okay? This is from your album, Just Right, okay? It says, you're some kind of royalty. Mm. I want to give you all my loyalty. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. I want to give you all my fidelity. Those are really good words, I'm telling you.
You found a new man in me. I feel God when you lay next to me.
Hey.
Mm-hmm. My God!
That was the last few.
Wait a minute. That's what it says.
Off on the
no, he didn't throw me out. The voice just sounds so good. But listen, what is it about love and your life experiences and relationships that have brought you to the point where that it made those words real for you?
Transparency, trial and error, and just being a work in progress. You know, whether. Sometimes the music is for me therapeutically, and sometimes it's you know, but first and foremost, it's always like a gift. I'm just a vessel for, you know, for the content.
Mm-hmm. I like the content. The words are off the chain. I like the content.
Yeah, yeah.
The music sounds so nice.
And the vehicle. The vehicle is straight, too. Your words are great. And speaking of vehicles going, too, I heard you're going all the way down to the Essence next week.
I am.
So what do you have lined up when you get there?
Well, I'm doing a performance at a spot called Tipitina's on the 4th. Myself, Brian McKnight. And a great list of other great soul R&B.
Put me on the list.
Performance.
You need to be there.
Put us on the list. Yeah. What are you doing?
Put us on the program.
And I'm also hosting the main stage during the day in the convention center with Roxy. You know what I mean?
Okay.
So I'll be there in another light. You know, as a tastemaker and a personality.
Mm-hmm.
And performing too on that Saturday on that same stage.
Well, y'all get
awesome. Thank you so much for coming to the circle. We love hanging out with you. And get his album. Thanks so much. Don't forget.
The Love Reunion.
Raheem's new album, The Love Reunion, is out today. On all streaming platforms.
All mom and pops. I got in stores happening in Atlanta. Follow me on the gram.
All right.